गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू टुडेज ऑनलाइन क्लास। सो द लास्ट वीडियो आई हैव स्टार्टेड योर थर्ड चैप्टर वेयर आई हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट वेरिएशन इन सेंटेंस। फर्स्ट आई टोल्ड यू अबाउट भीमबेटका रॉक शेल्टर ऑफ मध्य प्रदेश विच इज 9000 ईयर्स ओल्ड। And I also told you about the painting of the world of the cave. There have 400 paintings, and this painting gives us lots of information about the earliest man and their tools and their lifestyle. History of houses. So caves were the earliest form of the shelter of man. We know about it when they did hunting or food gathering. But after that, when they was beginning agriculture, a broad change in his life and the type of dwelling, because when they started agriculture, they also started living a settled life close to the water bodies. Because of facility of water nearest to the crop field, etc., they started building huts with branches and leaves of tree. And after that, early man discovered that the walls of the huts. I also told you there are several factors for affecting different types of settlement: landform, climate, materials. And after that, I also discussed about different types of shelter on the basis of landform. So in hilly area, we have seen some sloping roof, the tree where the buildings, their roofs are slopy. Why? Because it helps the snow and rain to slide off easily without damaging the roof. So such houses are found in Srinagar and Shimla in India. And after that, in plains, houses are built with thick walls and high flat roofs to keep them cool in summers. The material of construction are mainly cement and bricks in plain area. And in plain area, in high rise apartment building also found. And then after, I discuss about the settlement of coastal area, where the stilt house, you know about the stilt house, I have already discussed the last video. Now today, houses in earthquake prone area. Earthquake prone area means those area which are affected frequently by earthquake. Suppose Japan, where the building are built with bamboo and wood to minimize the damage to life and property. And rebuilding of such houses is not very difficult. If the houses made by bamboo and wood and damage it, so it can rebuild very easily. We live in a society because we are depend on other for the fulfillment of our needs. So we are all depend each other in our society. Or this is our community, and this community living, and this community teaches us to care for the other and share facility like water, electricity, roads, market. We need help in case of any disaster or losing of a home or getting injured. A neighborhood police station provides help and security. We also need service of hospital, ambulance and doctor to provide first aid. So these are the part of our society. Here having a story, sharing space with neighbors. So there was a farmer who grew the best quality corn. Every year he won many prizes. Once a newspaper reporter interviewed him and learned something very interesting. The farmer shared his corn seeds with his neighbors. How can you afford to share your corn seeds with your neighbors? So they are also entering the same competition with you, the reporter asked. Sir, said the farmer, the wind picks up pollen from the ripening corn and squirrels it from field to field. Hence, I share my corn seeds with all my neighbors so that we all grow good quality corn. How true. So here we can see that a farmer, he shared the corn to the neighbor. You cannot improve the quality of your life unless your neighbor's life improves. Those who want happiness must help others to find happiness. The welfare of each and every member of society is necessary. The story highlights the importance of our responsibility and teaches us community living. So create a new, happy, safe and comfortable neighborhood. So this chapter and this story, in this chapter there is a story of a farmer, teaches us that we should share some necessary things to the needy person of our society. And we know in our society we are dependent on each other, and in case of difficulties we should help to other, and our responsibility to care our neighbors. So in this way we can create a happy, safe and comfortable society and neighborhood across our country. The police encourages people to follow the neighborhood watch plan. Any suspicious character or activity in the locality must be reported by neighbors. It is a wonderful way of crime prevention and ensuring safety of residents, especially the elderly member and children. So we know the police station also encourages the people to follow the neighborhood watch plan. If any suspicious character we follow, we see, then we must have to report to the police station. Now, caring of neighbors. How you can care your neighbors? Most people keep their own homes neat and tidy from inside, but do not hesitate to throw the garbage on the street. Some people, they clean their home very neat and clean, but he throw the garbage on the street. See, do not hesitate. This is a very difficult situation. And imagine the condition of street if everyone acted in this manner. If every person do same work, if every person throw the garbage on the street, then what happened? We must keep the same cleanness standard for the surrounding that we keep for our house. A clean neighborhood does not have garbage heaps, filth, flies, mosquito, and unpleasant smells. So if I clean our neighboring area, if I clean our home, if I clean our nearabout roads, so then there having no garbage heaps, flies, mosquito, and unpleasant smell. So this is a good way. In this way, we can protect our society from diseases. Because we know if we have some garbage heaps, so there would be mosquito and flies, and it create lots of diseases. So as a good neighbor, we have some responsibilities. So as a good neighbor, we have some responsibility. What are the responsibilities? We should keep volume of radio and television low, especially at night. It's a very important point. We should not use noisy equipment at night like washing machine or vacuum cleaner. We must inform our neighbor in advance if we are having a party. We can also organize a carpool with neighbors and share the parking space peacefully. Always be ready to help your neighbor in case of an emergency. So these are the main point. So we should keep the volume of radio and television low, especially at night. We should not use noisy equipment at night like washing machine or vacuum cleaner. We must inform our neighbor in advance if we are having a party. We can also organize a carpool with neighbors and share the parking space peacefully. And always be ready to help your neighbors in case of an emergency. So these are the main point. Do you know, like human beings, ants and bees also live in a colonies? They work collectively as a social unit. It means they are also social as human being. They divide their works between female workers and male workers and the queen. So in this way, we have completed our third chapter and we learned lots of information from this chapter, lots of responsibilities, different types of house, etc. So the next class, you will get a PDF of question answer from this chapter. So I will solve this question and I will send you in next class. Thank you and have a nice day.